The rings are here to stay.
Imagine a scene from a futuristic sci-fi movie where a giant machine on the moon is spinning with incredible speed, preparing to launch something back towards Earth. It sounds like a wild fantasy, but in reality, Chinese scientists are working on making this a possibility, and we might see the implications sooner than later. Today's episode will uncover the futuristic new Chinese magnetic space launcher that is on its way to revolutionize moon mining. You heard that right. The Chinese scientists are developing a groundbreaking magnetic space launcher that could change the way we think about space travel and resource extraction, potentially solving some of Earth's most pressing energy issues. This ambitious project, estimated to cost around $18 billion, is being developed by researchers at the Shanghai Institute of Satellite Engineering, and it promises to be a game-changer in the world of space exploration. This innovative launcher, which the researchers have named a magnetic levitation facility, operates in a way that might remind you of an Olympic hammer thrower. Just like an athlete spins to build up momentum before releasing the hammer, this space device will spin and then launch materials from the moon's surface back to Earth. The concept is as simple as it is brilliant, using the principles of magnetic levitation to reduce the need for traditional fuel-based propulsion systems. This method not only makes the process more efficient, but also significantly cuts down the costs associated with transporting materials from space. Could this be the key to a new era of energy on Earth? We have to wait and see. One thing is for certain, the economic advantages are there, and this device will be completely revolutionary and not just in theory. The moon has always fascinated scientists, and now, with China's growing space ambitions, it is being seen as more than just a distant celestial body. China, in collaboration with Russia, has proposed the construction of a research station on the lunar South Pole by 2035. This station could serve as a base for various scientific experiments and, more importantly, as a hub for resource extraction. The magnetic launcher could play a crucial role in this venture, especially when it comes to transporting valuable resources like helium-3 back to Earth. Helium-3, an isotope found on the lunar surface, holds the promise of a cleaner and more efficient form of nuclear energy. According to the Shanghai researchers, just 20 tons of helium-3 could power China for an entire year, offering a potential solution to the country's growing energy needs. Now, you might be thinking an important question that we're all thinking right now, which is, how does this magnetic launcher work and why is it so revolutionary? The device will operate solely on electricity, harnessing energy from solar and nuclear sources available on the moon. By utilizing the moon's unique environment, its high vacuum and low gravity, the launcher can send payloads back to Earth at a fraction of the cost of current methods. The researchers estimate that it will be able to do this twice a day, reducing transport costs to just 10% of what they are today. The launcher itself will be a massive structure, weighing in at 80 metric tons, around 88 US tons, and will need to be transported to the moon using China's heavy lift rocket, the Long March 9. This project represents not just a technical challenge, but also a significant logistical one. Yet, the potential rewards could be enormous. One might wonder, what are the challenges that this ambitious project might face? The moon's surface is not an easy place to work. The rocky terrain and extreme temperature fluctuations could pose significant technical hurdles. The researchers are well aware of these challenges, and overcoming them will be crucial to the success of the project. The exact timeline for the construction and implementation of the launcher is still uncertain, but once it is operational, it is expected to last for up to 20 years on the moon's surface. The idea of having a device on the moon that could continually send valuable resources back to Earth for two decades is nothing short of extraordinary. Could this be the future of energy? China's interest in helium-3 is not just a passing curiosity. The isotope is seen as a potential game changer in the field of nuclear energy, particularly in the development of nuclear fusion. Unlike the nuclear fission reactions used in today's power plants, which produce long-lived radioactive waste, nuclear fusion promises to be a much cleaner and more sustainable source of energy. Helium-3 could be the key to unlocking this potential, and the Moon is one of the few places where it is found in significant quantities. By bringing this resource back to Earth, China could position itself at the forefront of the next energy revolution. What would it mean for the world if China succeeds in harnessing helium-3? Well, probably. The stakes are high and the investment is enormous. The projected cost of 130 billion yuan, approximately 18.2 billion, reflects the scale of the challenge. However, the potential benefits are equally vast. If successful, the magnetic space launcher could not only provide a steady supply of helium-3, but also open up new possibilities for space exploration and resource extraction. It could pave the way for future missions to other celestial bodies, where similar techniques could be used to mine resources and bring them back to Earth. The idea of turning space into a resource-rich frontier is no longer confined to the realm of science fiction. The challenges facing this ambitious project are formidable. The Moon's rugged, uneven terrain and its extreme temperature fluctuations pose significant technical obstacles. The harsh lunar environment could affect the performance and durability of the magnetic launcher, requiring some advanced materials and engineering solutions to ensure its long-term functionality. Transporting the 80-ton launcher to the Moon and assembling it in such a hostile environment is another difficult task. Yet China has a track record of overcoming seemingly impossible challenges through innovation and determination. Drawing on its extensive experience in space exploration, China is well equipped to tackle these hurdles. The country's advancements in materials science, robotics, and space technology provide a strong foundation for addressing the technical complexities of this project. China's successful lunar missions, including the Chang'e series, demonstrate its ability to operate in the challenging conditions of the Moon. By leveraging its technological prowess and strategic partnerships, particularly with Russia, China is poised to overcome these challenges and bring this revolutionary project to life. The success of this endeavor could solidify China's position as a leader in space exploration, marking a new chapter in the global race for space-based resources. As China continues to push the boundaries of space exploration, it is clear that the country's ambitions go far beyond mere scientific curiosity. This magnetic space launcher is just one part of a strategy to establish a strong presence in space and leverage the resources available there. China's collaboration with Russia on the Lunar Research Station is a sign to the growing importance of international partnerships in space. Together, these two nations are aiming to achieve something that was once thought to be impossible, creating a sustainable and economically viable method of transporting resources from space to Earth. With much about the futuristic new Chinese magnetic space launcher that is on its way to revolutionize moon mining covered, it is time to wrap this one up. If you have any topics in mind, comment below and we will cover them for you. As always, subscribe to never miss out. This is Race to Space, and we will see you in the next one.